you know, earlier in the week, we were talking about what we were going to talk about today, and Josh had some ideas just like last week. And so we're going to go ahead and start off with one of his ideas tonight. We're going to start off by talking about the Taylor Swift, the Eras Tour. And Josh, why don't you tell us what you thought about this?
Actually, I thought it was excellent. We started watching it. I thought it was great.
Okay, good, because I didn't see it. All right, for any Swifties that are out there that may have seen this, don't be leaving your comments in the section. This was just a joke. We're just trying to.
Taylor Swift on this podcast, all right?
I have a 7-year-old daughter. I'm like listening all to the right. song every day on my way, taking her to school.
No, but seriously, though, Josh did have an idea. He wanted to talk about some of the trailers that dropped this week. Specifically, we wanted to talk about the Rebel Moon and the Acolyte trailers. And we're going to go ahead and watch those here and see what we think about those. So we're going to check those out. But first off, before we get into that, Derek, did you see Rebel Moon Part 1?
Nope.
Okay, so I'm interested to see what you think after you see this trailer, because you're going to be seeing this from an outside perspective, and I want to know if you're interested at all to see this movie.
Yeah.
Now, let me just point out that I looked down Rotten Tomatoes today, and
of course,
Rebel Moon has something like 20% or something among critics. If you look at top critics, it's like 8%, and amongst the audience, it's like in the 50s. So not exactly a very well-liked film. And now Josh and I happened to like it the first time that we saw it. But I did tell Josh that I did think that there were a few issues here and there with the film. And I thought that some of the criticisms out there were valid. So we'll see what we think about part two with this trailer. And then, of course, the Acolyte. I know Josh and I are, but are you familiar at all what's going on with Star Wars right now?
I've got a little bit of an idea. I got a chance to like check out that trailer, but it actually was just by chance because like YouTube popped it up randomly. Okay. So I'm like, all right, well, let's take a look at this. And so I get the idea, I think, of what's going on.
All right.
Maybe we can talk about film and, you know.
Yeah, okay. Because if you can hear that toilet flushing, that's probably Star Wars that you're hearing in the background.
I was going to mention this. Like, do we even have to do this? Are you just going to dumpster fire it now and then we just move on?
No, we're not going to be biased towards anything. We're just going to talk about the trailer. Simple.
I do want to give this an actual shot. Because I do think that there were a few things in the trailer that look kind of interesting. So let's go ahead and let's watch these two trailers and we'll talk about it. So the first thing we're going to do, we'll go ahead and watch Rebel Moon and see what we think about this. Let me go ahead and share the screen. All right, gentlemen, this is the trailer for Rebel Moon. Now, just so you know, Derek, that's not a lightsaber.
Is you not
they wouldn't know.
You cannot win.
You're here. Because there is nothing to return to. Dark days lie ahead of us all. We will teach you how to fight. That's impressive. The Scargivers among them. Those this village holds most dear. I shall destroy them.
Have no choice but to fight.
God,
Scoggy by herself.
Go!
Are you truly prepared to allow this to continue in your name?
I'm sorry. I won't allow this place to die for me.
All right, so there we got Rebel Moon Part 2. And Derek, I'm not sure if you're too again, since you didn't watch the first film, apparently Rebel Moon was supposed to be a Star Wars project that Zack Snyder had in mind back when Disney first bought Star Wars. They ended up not going with that idea. They wanted to do their own trilogy. And so years later, now he's taken the idea and fleshed it out into his own movies. There is also a rated R version of this that he's going to do because apparently Netflix told him, okay, you can go make the movie that you want to make, but give us two parts, PG-13, and then later you can release your part. So there's supposed to be extended cuts, both part one and two, that are supposed to come out together. So now, as an outsider, what did you think of this trailer? Are you interested at all in seeing this film?
When you throw Zack Snyder's name at me, I'm not going to be against it. I've been a pretty big fan of his. I'm not sure what you guys said about it, but I guess we'll call it the Snyder cut. I believe that's a term now.
Yes.
Of the Justice League when it came out on Max. You guys remember that?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Four years ago, right?
Yeah.
4 years ago today?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I enjoyed it actually quite a bit because it ran like more of like a mini series. Like you could watch it in parts, which I thought was that was a nice effect because, you know, chapter 1 through 6. And I actually thought it was pretty well done. Most of what Zack Snyder does, I'm a fan of. I didn't know that was actually supposed to be a Star Wars project, which is what it looked like.
Because that's totally not a lightsaber, just so you know.
Yes. No, that was a glowing sword, not a lightsaber. Difference. But I can't say I won't. I'm up for it. It looks good. Right.
Okay.
Now you guys did see the movie, so can I ask what you guys thought? What was it about? Because I'm new to this.
Okay. Essentially, the first part, you've got this. Well, first off, it takes place like in this, not the Empire. You know, in a galaxy not the Empire is kind of running everything. And I guess their king died? And
yes. Yeah. Their king died. From what I remember. Yeah.
Yeah. And so the not Empire and the not space Nazis, stormtroopers and stuff that they got are kind of now running everything. And there's this character who's the main character. She's hiding out on this planet who used to be one of their soldiers. And of course she kind of gets thrust back into everything. And the whole movie, she's kind of putting this team together to defend this planet. And then that's where the second part's supposed to pick up, the actual defense of this planet.
Who are not Jedis?
Yeah.
Jedis. Yeah. I really like the villain. I like this movie. And Bobby knows that. Bobby liked it too. It was interesting. I thought both of you have known me for a long time. And, you know, I tend to fall asleep, you know, when I'm watching something. It takes me a couple days to, you know, watch it. I could not stop watching this movie. Like, I did not fall asleep. I thought it flowed very easily. I think you would like it, Derek. I think
Yeah, I remember you giving it high praise. But then why did it get so trashed?
Now,
that's what I don't know.
You know, here's a couple things. I do think that some of the criticisms of it are very valid. And I'm beginning to think that maybe I just happen to like a bad movie. And that's okay. Because
it happens.
Because there are bad movies out there that you just happen to like for whatever reason. And I'm not saying it was the greatest movie ever. But I enjoyed it. I liked it. I didn't have a problem with it when I first saw it. And I know I'm apparently in the minority on this one. And I think part of that is because Zack Snyder's films are incredibly divisive. They just tend to be. And I heard a critic say it this way. He said he described Zack Snyder as spicy food. And you have to like spicy food. You either do or you don't. You're not going to have the in-between. And so because of that, you either like his films or you don't like his films. And I think that's kind of the case here. So if you weren't a Snyder fan to begin with, I don't think that this movie was going to win you over.
Okay.
I think that was part of the issue there. Again, I don't think it was the greatest movie ever, but I was entertained by it. I liked it. But again, I'm beginning to think that I just happen to like a bad movie.
And if anyone okay. who's watching our podcast, comment in the section and let us know why you didn't like it. Because I would love
to. Oh, trust me, they probably will.
Yeah, I don't think you're going to have to worry about that.
like I said, this seems to be a universally disliked film. So the part one. So maybe part two be better. Maybe because it looks like it's got a lot of action in it. And I'm willing to give it a shot and see how part two is.
I have a feeling a lot of this, like a lot of this criticism has to do with the fact that it looks like Star Wars.
Yeah, it could.
I think that's probably where a lot of this comes into play, but that's a great way to sum up Zack Snyder. That's right on the money there in terms of spicy food. That's exactly right.
Well, yeah, like that's I said, I wish I could take credit for that one, but I heard somebody say that. And I think it's a great analogy when it comes to Zack Snyder.
Money. Yep.
All right. Well, let's go ahead and check out the Acolyte trailer. And let's see what we think about this one here. All right.
Close your eyes. Your eyes can deceive you. We must not trust them. Tell me what comes into your mind.
Lion. Balance. I see fire.
Someone is killing Jedi. It doesn't make sense.
What happened?
I sensed the darkness.
This isn't about good or bad. This is about power and who is allowed to use it.
What is that?
All right, so there we got the Acolyte.
What? Was that a red lightsaber? I thought the Sith have been extinct.
All right, Josh, why don't you tell us how you really feel about this? I want to point out before we get into that, I was looking earlier, and apparently this trailer has been ratioed as far as there are more downvotes than there are upvotes for this trailer.
All I can say is,
that was the last I heard. So,
all I can say is Star Wars is not back, baby. Let me tell you what, it looks like a samurai movie. Like, it doesn't even like... Okay, so for Derek, I know, you know, Star Wars isn't necessarily your thing, but I don't know if you saw, I think you did, The Phantom Menace?
Yeah.
Right, okay. So in The Phantom Menace, one of the Jedi, when they first, you know, found out about Darth Maul, they said the Sith have been extinct for a millennium. This movie takes place what is it, 50? We don't even know.
100 50
years or 100? Well, that's been undecided, actually. They've gone back and forth with that.
I think it's 100 years from last I heard. Okay,
so let's say it's been 100 years before Phantom Menace. Now you're saying all of a sudden there's a dark force going around. You have a red lightsaber. And the problem with this movie, I was telling somebody today, one of my other friends, was that if you go ahead and do this, and Bob, you don't even know what I'm about to say, then whoever finds the Sith, that Sith's going to have to kill that Jedi and then any other Jedi who know about it. And it's going to get so complicated. You know what I mean? It's like, I don't know. It's ridiculous.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
Go ahead.
Were those lightsabers?
Yes, they were. That was funny.
You said in Red Moon they weren't.
I know. Well,
that was different, though, because that was Rebel Moon. You see, now this was a Star Wars project. So, those were lightsabers.
I mean, here is somebody in one of those first scenes. She's fighting against the person with a knife, and then she barely uses the Force. I mean, where's her lightsaber? Like, what is, I don't know. Bob, you want to?
Well, first off, I want to know what Derek thought as an outsider here. Do you have any interest in this?
I mean, the Star Wars is kind of like a tricky thing to me because, you know, I've only seen like, you know, the first six. That's like all I know. So
keep it that way.
Okay. You don't leave it alone after that. But
you haven't missed anything.
Well, yeah, no, you said if I was ever interested in watching just something awful, then I want to head over and watch 7, 8, and 9 from what you told me.
Did I say that?
Yes.
Oh, that sounds like me. Yeah.
Yeah. But then I know my sister was a big fan of Rogue One.
Okay, now I will say, Rogue One was good. So if you do watch anything out of the Disney era, Rogue One would be it. So I don't want to sit here and pretend that I'm a Disney hater when it comes to Star Wars because I did really like Rogue One. I think
if you are a Disney hater.
I think of I think a few of the cartoons have actually been decent. And Josh knows this. I'm not really a big cartoon guy when it comes to Star Wars because Star Wars to me is a motion picture event. It should be. And the best part of Star Wars should not be the cartoons. So the fact that some of their cartoons were better than their movies, to me, that's a problem. Yeah. And so that's kind of the way I look at the cartoons. But I'm not going to lie. Some of them I thought were pretty good. I thought Tales of the Jedi was decent. And I thought the Clone Wars was good. So I don't want to sit here and be a hater on it all. Because, again, I do think they've done some good things.
Yeah.
If you do watch any of them, Rogue One would be it.
Okay. And I did have a good time with The Mandalorian.
Love The Mandalorian. Seasons one and two.
The first two seasons are pretty good.
Yeah.
The third season was dog water.
Got it. Dumpster fire. Okay.
I don't know if it was it was pretty close, but I was thinking more along the lines of stale dog water.
just
right, Josh.
I totally agree with you.
Just right before you get to the dumpster fire, it's going to be that big old bowl of stale dog water.
Yeah, and the worst part was that they brought in, you know, a classic actor like Christopher Lloyd to come in for one of the episodes in Mandalorian Season 3. And good Lord, he's casted in an episode with Jack Black and Lizzo, of all people. And they've got this whole scene going on. Where he's turning around, he's talking to Lizzo and Jack Black, and he's like, "My lady, I'm sorry." And you've got Lizzo. She's like, "Maybe I can forgive you, but now you must go into exile." And you've got Jack Black sitting there, and he's like, "I knew you didn't like me." And I'm just like, "What the heck is this? This
is
Star Wars."
You mentioned Christopher Lloyd. Now you want me to? Now I want Derek to do his impression for Back of the Future 3. You got that in my head now.
What? Oh yeah, I'm way off base. That's how he was. So it wasn't the episode.
Oh my god, this is too good.
Okay, so now I'm not gonna lie. Part of me is intrigued. It's like
don't watch it.
You made him want to watch
it. I'm telling you, if you go and you watch that episode, you're going to waste 30 minutes of your life.
Okay. Well, I got some time before I start work. So
oh my god.
Yeah.
Oh. Well, there you go, man. You might as well watch it then.
Oh god.
Yeah.
All right.
It's funny that we're talking about this because my oldest, you know, is kind of intrigued by the idea of Star Wars. And mm-hmm. and to be fair, like way back when, the first three, like 4, 5, and 6 were my jam as a kid. I had a Star Wars tent that I camp out on our like back patio.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah. My favorite movie, like maybe even to this day, it could stay in my top 5, maybe. Is Return of the Jedi.
Interesting.
Yeah,
that's very interesting.
I loved that movie when I was a kid. And I got a chance to revisit it again like when I was older. And I'm like, man, this still holds up. This is great.
I think that the originals hold up very well.
Yeah, they do. So I'm thinking, you know, maybe, you know, we could... He's not ready for, like, the MCU quite yet. Because if we're going to do that, I want to start from, like, beginning with, you know, Iron Man. But the first scene in Iron Man is, like, when terrorists blow up the Humvee. So,
now, what you should do is if you show them the MCU, you watch Phase 1, 2, and 3, and you stop when you get to Phase 4. I mean, 4. And then from there, you could watch maybe Spider-Man No Way Home and maybe Guardians 3. But otherwise, leave Phase 4, I mean, 4 alone.
The rise and fall of the MCU.
I gotta save Spider-Man for him because that's his favorite. That's number one for him. He's a big Spider-Man fan.
I did really like No Way Home, so.
Oh, that was a great one. They did a fantastic job on that movie.
Well, I think that's
actually about the Acolyte, Bob? What do you think about it? You didn't dissect the trailer for us. Tell us what you think.
Let's see. I do agree with you, Josh. I mean, look, they're going to have to pretty much kill everybody because if they don't, they're retconning an entire movie. And I mean, I wouldn't put it past them to do it. But look, when it comes to Lucasfilm, I don't exactly have high hopes for them. And I've talked to Josh about this before, that part of the problem that I have with Lucasfilm is that I feel like it's a restaurant that you go to and they serve you a bad meal. And it's okay if you get one bad meal, but after you get another one and another one and another one, then you finally decide you're not going to go to the restaurant. And then where Lucasfilm frustrates me is that they've had several people that have been affiliated with them or affiliated with them directly or work for them directly that then turn around and kind of say it's your fault why you didn't like it. That's like if you go to this restaurant and you get all these bad meals and then the restaurant staff tells you that it's your fault. So that's kind of the way that I feel with Lucasfilm. So there are a couple things in this trailer I think that look kind of interesting. So, I mean, I'm willing to watch it, at least give it a shot, but I don't have a whole lot of high hopes for that.
Like what are we on? What was the last Star Wars? Was it the last Star Wars thing they did? The Mandalorian? Was that it?
No. Yeah. Mandalorian season 3, right? No.
Ahsoka.
Yeah. Ahsoka.
You're right.
Ahsoka.
You're right. Okay. Ahsoka. I mean, Ahsoka.
And they have Bad Batch on right now, which is very good. Really okay. Like Bad Batch.
I wanted to like Ahsoka, and Josh will tell you, I actually kind of liked the first few episodes. They had some problems, but overall, I enjoyed them. And then it fell off a cliff, especially instead of getting Grand Admiral Thrawn, we got, you know, Walmart Grand Admiral Thrawn. It was like I'm a big dude, so I mean, I feel like I can say this with some confidence here.
God.
It looks like that he went to Dunkin' Donuts, you know, prior to.
Oh my God, we're gonna get kicked off.
You know, so it just didn't match with what we saw him in the way he's described in the books and the way we saw him in Rebels. I mean, I don't know. It looked really bad. I mean, you know, and then finally, at the way the whole show ends, I mean, I don't even want to get into it. So, and you know, it's bad when Josh says that it was bad because he loves Ahsoka as far as a character goes.
I do. I love the first 5 episodes, and it just went downhill. And they could have taken it to a much different place that would have been much more enjoyable.
Okay, so pass.
Yeah.